Hello everyone, Crydax here, and welcome back to Tier Listing Everything in Factorio Space Age. We have now done automation and logistics, and we're going to work through the intermediates tab today, which is going to be an interesting one. I think it's going to require a slightly different approach to some of these, and we will want to think about what they are used in and things like that, because obviously the intermediates themselves don't do anything in most cases. So we will have to change a little bit of our criteria. We will have to lean a little bit heavier on some of the unique factors or the graphics or, yeah, exactly, vibe checks, Luke. So we'll see how this goes, but I think we're just gonna jump right in. I guess we'll just start with this advanced circuit. Gosh, I hate how slow red chips go. So they're going in D, right? Like, I have felt multiple times like you need more red chips than you need blue chips or green chips. And that's always felt weird to me. And I think it's mostly just because of the recipe time being so long compared to how many you end up using in your base. I do think we should probably do science packs together. So for now, we'll skip science. These are in alphabetical order, clearly. Let's go with wood. Where does wood go? Is wood just a straight up F? This is another one of the, because, and again, I realize this is me being biased in some ways, but because you spend so much of your playthrough, whether it's a modded player who's playing a more advanced overhaul mod pack, or whether it's now the default vanilla Space Age playthrough, so much of the playthrough is at a point where wood doesn't even exist anymore. Now, what's kind of interesting is they've added it back into the end game, or, well, the late-ish game. After you've gone to Gleba, you can then plant trees on Navis to remove pollution, which is kind of cool. But wood itself has basically zero purpose in the game other than something to move past. So I'm giving it an F because it's pretty useless. In mod packs, it can go a lot higher, but I think in Factorio as it stands, wood is kind of an F. I mean, I've seen countless pictures over the years of, you know, the burner inserter chain just to try to get rid of wood. So that tells you something. Empty barrel. So remember, things get a C by default unless I have a reason move them. So I think empty barrels kind of go in that. They're cheap, they're plentiful, they only stack to 10, which is a little low, but they do what you need to do. I don't know. I got nothing. Batteries. Ugh. Batteries always feel expensive to me too. I think from a craft time perspective, because the sulfuric acid doesn't seem like that much, but it really adds up. And I think you end up like using way more oil than you think you're using. Like, batteries are sneaky expensive because they feel cheap in terms of copper and iron. I don't even know if I could tell you how expensive batteries are. I don't remember the price. Is it one copper and one iron in vanilla Factorio? I've played too many mod packs. My brain is addled with different recipes. But yeah, I think the fact that they cost more oil than they look like is the tricky part. Galdok, welcome everybody, welcome raiders. For those who don't know, Galdok is a wonderful streamer who, are you currently working on playing Factorio or modding Factorio? Either way, welcome. You guys should go give Galdok a follow. Today was modding, nice. What are you working on? Art for what? Your Galdok's manufacturing or otherwise? What's up, SMO and not Melon? Oh, you were working on art for the Miraxis mod that not Melon is making. Awesome. Yeah, for everyone watching, you guys should go check out the Miraxis mod. It's not done yet, but it will be done hopefully soon. It's a whole new planet that has you underwater, and you have to make like pressure chambers, and it's really cool. It's out now already? Officially? Amazing. Go get it, everybody. Go play it. I need to go play it. Anyway, So, where am I putting green circuits? Green circuits feel like the god item, right? Like they are, I mean, they are the freaking Factorio. Oh, you can't see it because of the green screen. How do I, hold on. Video capture device, filters, comma key. Green circuit, yes. So yeah, green circuits I think are S tier. They are maybe the most iconic Factorio item other than the gear itself potentially, but even that's the wrong color to be the Factorio icon. There are no copper gears. Yeah, see you later, Galdok. Have fun. So yeah, I don't know. I don't know if they deserve S though for that alone. I'm a little undecided. They're at least an A though. They're just the Factorio item. Green chips, you know? The green chips are so great. Now blue chips are really cool, but I think they just solidly deserve to be a C tier. They're really expensive. That's a knock on them. I think they look the coolest. They're my favorite color of the three. But also I maybe I'm bumping them up. B for blue. Because they go in all of the coolest recipes. Like once you have blue circuits, now you can make I can't think of a single thing. Now you can make the nuclear backpack. I forget what it's called, the portable fission reactor. You can make exoskeletons, you can make tier 2 modules, you can make all sorts of cool stuff. So, or wait, no, tier 2 modules are not blue chips. Are tier 2 modules just red chips? They're just red and green. Yeah, now you can make tier 3 modules. Anyway, yeah, power armor. Yeah, exactly. So that's all pretty good. That's all pretty good. Maybe we should do all the ores. Let's find all the ores here. Let's see. Stone. I probably need to pick up the pace. There's like over 100 items in this category. Is that all of them? Probably missed one. Stone. Stone is fine. I'm gonna give it a D because the patches are small and you don't get it from asteroids. I was chatting with someone in YouTube comments about, I think it could be interesting to have asteroids over Aquilo specifically that give stone. It just feels weird that you literally can't get rock when you're demolishing thousands of asteroids in space. You can get everything else, but you can't get rock. Just feels wrong. Iron ore, copper, solid workhorses of the ore world. Coal gets a C because it's not raw coal and it doesn't make me think about ash. What about these new ores? Uranium's not new. Uranium, I like the shiny green. Stone is F tier. There's no stone asteroid and it's a waste. It is a waste product on Vulcanus, that's for sure. Okay, what about all the new ones? Calcite is really strong. Between funding your foundries and also funding the recipe to make insane amounts of high temperature steam, it is just really strong. It only stacks to 50, but that's true of most ores. But calcite in particular, you ship from planet to planet more so than the other ores. So I do wish it stacked to 100, but oh well, not everything can be perfect. What about tungsten? Tungsten's a little weird. Tungsten requires you to have killed some demolishers, but it doesn't require much else. I think it goes into C. Tungsten's fine. It's a cool color. I like the purple color. Holmium is F tier. Freaking hate holmium, man. The only way you can get it is by recycling massive amounts of scrap. And you're always short on holmium ore, and there's no way to get more holmium ore without just recycling more scrap. And then you're having to trash all the... I mean, don't get me wrong, I love Fulgora and its mechanics, so I'm not complaining about that. I'm just making a point. Holmium sucks. Yeah, I really appreciated when I finally took foundries to Fulgora to make holmium plates with foundries. That helped. All right, moving on. Let's do the basics of like what you can make out of iron and copper. We'll do these guys. Yeah. Holmium is hard to quality. That's actually a really relevant point for it being F as well. That's kind of annoying. I actually considered for a moment, I was like, should they? Because right now the recipe for holmium plate is just fluid holmium. What's it called? Holmium solution. And I actually wonder if they should make it holmium solution plus holmium ore. Like a tiny bit of like one holmium ore plus some holmium solution or something. But then at the same time, that makes it too easy to get high quality holmium plates. So maybe it should be about half and half. I don't know. Either way. Because you can't force high quality holmium plates. So holmium is not homie. It's not my homie. All right. Iron plates, copper plates. Go back there. Where do these go? You always need more iron until you start running out of copper, and then you need more copper. You need both, and you need a lot of both, and I like that. I don't know. I think C is the correct place for these. They are iconic, but I don't think they belong too high. I don't know. Sticks. I'm gonna put sticks. Hot take, but they're pretty low for me, because they're only used in buildings, right? And so it's not like you're ever really putting sticks on a belt, unless they're just being taken right off the belt, because you're dealing with the maul. So I feel like iron sticks are one of those. It's just there to have more recipes in the game, type thing, or maybe for lore reasons. But in most places, sticks could be replaced with gears, and the game would not feel any different. Other than it would be slightly easier, right? Because then you'd have less things to make. So I don't actually value sticks that high. I think gears are cool. I think they're cool because they densify the iron, right? You know, you need to make like one gear is two iron. So a belt of gears is kind of this trade-off where you're like, ooh, I need gears in lots of places. And this way I can have less belts on my bus because I can put gears on the bus. But then that means I've locked in the iron to being a gear forever. And so you kind of, yeah, it's a cool trade-off. I like gears. Go gears. Copper wire gets a C because unlike gears, it does not make the item denser. It makes the item less dense. So, but it's also used in circuits and you need lots and lots and lots of it. And I think wire is kind of fun as like a challenge of like, how do you get this many items around your base? Because the number of copper wire per second you need is huge. And I think this item by itself has taught more players the beauty of direct insertion assembler builds, where you have, you know, the classic like two assemblers with three circuit assemblers feeding it from the other side, which now with the new electromagnetic plants that probably doesn't apply anymore. But the old build, I think, taught a lot of players like, oh, you can have some of the ingredients being inserted directly. And that's a cool thing. So good job, copper wire. Good on you, mate. It's cool because it's always the number one most produced item. That is true. All right, what's next? Steel? Steel, the workhorse of the base. I do not like the 5-to-1 ratio. I actually think it's kind of too much. And maybe that's just because I've played too many mods where it's not 5-to-1. But it's so dense compared to iron. So I can't give it above a C. I don't know if that knocks it down to D, but it definitely keeps it from going up to a B. All right, what's next? Engines, maybe? Ugh, barf. They're slow. They take one thing that's expensive, which is steel, and then two things that are really cheap, which is a pipe and a gear. And so you only need like one pipe maker and one gear maker for like 20 engine makers. And then, you know what? Those go in D because electric engines need to be even lower. Oh, and then they need lube and you got the pipes everywhere, but you need like 50 assemblers. Oh, it's so much. And you need a lot of electric engines. They're just one of my least favorite things to automate is the engine plus electric engine line. I don't have great reasons for it, but there we are. Explosives. Ooh, exciting. Explosives are... What are they? I think explosives are B tier because they tend to make things that are exciting to make. So if you're making explosives, that probably means you're about to have some fun, right? You're about to make some cannon shells or, you know, maybe some... I don't know. What else do explosives make? Cliff explosives, artillery shells, grenades. Explosives are fun. What else is kind of in the earlier game category? Ooh, steam. Steam is interesting. All the fluids. Yeah, foundries making engines could make sense. I could see that. Also the seeds here. Let's go with solid fuel. Well, maybe we should start with oil. Crude oil. I've always liked the oil processing chains and all that comes of it. And the crude oil is the root of all of that beautiful stuff. I think crude oil gets an A. I don't know about S, but it gets an A. Solid fuel, I think, is really cool. You can use it for trains. You can use it to fuel your base, and it's more efficient than coal. I feel like it tends to be pretty strong in mod packs, though that's not something we've been grading things based on. But it is pretty nice. I do like me some solid fuel. I'll give it a C. Water. I mean water. S or F? It gets in the way. It's annoying. You have to landfill it. But it's also what... literally 70% of our bodies are made of. I think water, from an actual gameplay perspective, I think water is just kind of annoying. It's just something you have to pipe around, and you always have enough of it because of how offshore pumps work. Maybe that's part of... I was talking about offshore pumps in the previous video where I don't think we gave them a good grade, and I think it's just because they're really boring. They're not that interesting. There's no nuance to offshore pumps. You place one, boom, enough water forever. Especially with the new steam changes. I mean, one offshore pump is enough for an entire giant nuclear plant now. So I don't think water is that interesting as a fluid. I ironically think water got even more boring with Space Age. I like the fluid changes overall, but they now mean that water, you don't even need multiple pipelines of it anymore. Just one pipe is enough forever for everything. The ice, on that note, ice is S tier. I really like the idea of having to get ice and then melt it down into water, and then that's actually a limited resource. That's an interesting mechanic. Ice is S tier. Luke, you don't want water to be hard? But that's what ice is hard water. but yes, no, I get what you're saying, that water being difficult wouldn't be that fun either. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know exactly what I'm saying, but I don't think water deserves to be above C. Water filtration, yeah. It's just hard because I feel like a lot of my complaints, sometimes the answer feels like, well, then it needs to be more complicated for me to like it more, but then it's too complicated for the game. So I think to some level, I've become a jaded player that only finds enjoyment in stuff that's harder than it should be. and I don't know if that makes me the best judge of regular Factorio anymore. anyway, I'm trying to reorganize the science packs here. There's a lot of science packs. Holy wowzers. All right, let's get to Steam. Where's Steam? I like Steam a lot. Where is it? There it is. Boom. S tier. Apparently, I like two forms of water more than the third. So Steam is cool. because first of all, I've already talked about how I like the heat mechanic and like heat pipes and stuff. And I really like different temperatures of steam having different power capacities, essentially, like how many joules are stored in one unit of steam. I really like that. I really like that now one unit of water makes 10 units of steam, and I like steam power. I think it's cool to have steam power early, but then later when you have really cool nuclear power, it's still steam power. It's just hotter steam. So I don't know. I think steam is pretty sweet. I don't know if it should be S though. I think A is more appropriate because it's really not, you know, you've got fusion power, you've got solar power, like it's got some pretty strong competitors. So a water train feels silly, and a pipeline just to get a bit of water also feels stupid. Yeah, I do agree there should be a groundwater pump in the base game, at least on Nauvis. I think that would be nice. Now what? Plastic? Let's grab our kind of core, like, oil processing stuff. Okay, so plastic, heavy, light, and petroleum. I think the changes they made to oil were good. I also think they're hilariously simple, but that the old way oil worked was where pretty much all the new players who got stuck were getting stuck on oil. And so I think from a design perspective, it was good that they made the basic oil processing just like straight up crude to petroleum. But it's made me like petroleum less because of it, because you can just get it. It's too easy. I think it's probably good for the game that it's that easy, but I don't like it. I like the advanced oil cracking into light and heavy oil and needing to deal with cracking those. And needing water for that actually is interesting again, because you're mixing water with another fluid and that's more interesting. So I like oil cracking as a mechanic. I like the balancing of it. I find it fun. Plastic is cool. I don't know if it deserves above a C though. I think it's just a C. It's plastic. You make it with coal and petroleum. I've always found it kind of annoying that you need coal, because often that's the first thing, and I guess only thing, that you use. Oh yeah, sorry. I'm an old man. When I say new oil changes, yes, I do mean the changes that they made like 5 years ago. Before, I think it was before Factorio 1.0 even released. I don't remember the order it happened in, but yeah, that is the change I'm talking about. anyway, all that to say, is coal an ingredient in anything else? I guess grenades, right? Is that the only other thing? Grenades, plastic. Wait, is it in explosives? No. No, it's just grenades. Yeah, so I do sometimes get annoyed when I'm setting up plastic, because it's like, oh, now I gotta go get a belt of coal from somewhere that I wasn't really ready for. But other than that, I think plastic is fine. And then that brings us to, I think, low density structure, which is just so expensive. I gotta knock it down a peg for that. It's so, I mean, you never knew that so much copper could even exist on the planet until you try to start making low density structure, and then you just starved for copper forever. Basically impossible. Basically. Let's see, are there any other default items, or is this all space agey stuff and barrels? Oh, flying robot frames, S tier, because they enable the best thing in the game, which is robots. Yes, please. No, they're kind of annoying with electric engines though. I gotta knock them down a peg for that. They're so slow. Oh, they're so slow. Why are they so slow? It's fine, you just need 20 assemblers for them. Sulfur. Sulfur and sulfuric acid are interesting. How do I feel about these guys? When I look at this icon, does it spark joy? Excuse me. Yeah, I like sulfuric acid. I don't like sulfur though. Sulfur in its solid form has always felt kind of annoying. So I'll leave it at C. I don't have any good reasons to knock it down to D, but I'm not going to bump it up. Didn't they need to change the cost in Space Age? Of what, Templar? Sorry, I don't know what subject. What else is still on Nalvis? I guess the uranium stuff. Oh, solid fuel. Or rocket fuel. Rocket fuel is awesome. I love rocket fuel. I love once you start producing it and it's just this really dense fuel and it makes your trains go faster. You need it to produce rockets. You can put it in your tank to go faster. I think rocket fuel is pretty cool. I have zero complaints about rocket fuel. And it's pretty cheap, especially once you get productivity going with your chem plants. Yeah, rocket control units were removed from Space Age. This is interesting that it's here because it's not technically an item you can put on a belt in the game, but it is an item that has a recipe for it in the rocket silo. So that's a little bit of a exception. Anyway, uranium stuff. Let's look at all the uranium goodies here. So, uranium. So these are like the recipes, not necessarily the items, because these two are just these three are just recipes. So let's rate the items first then. So the dark green rocks, annoying. They clog up your whole world. You don't care about them unless you're making uranium ammo. And who makes uranium ammo? Uranium ammo has to be one of, spoiler alert for when I get to the military tab. It's like the most loser of all the ammos. And I know some of you are gonna be like, oh my God, in my playthrough, I needed uranium ammo. But like, by the time you need uranium ammo, if you can't make a wall of lasers that is just in all ways better than turrets, then you're doing something wrong. Or you're playing a different game mode, like, you know, what's it called? You know, the one with all the biters? You know, Death World? There we go, Death World. That being said, it has no use. Its only use is to turn into shiny green rocks, which get S tier, because they're beautiful, and I want to hold one, even though it might kill me. I just want one, and I want to have it on my desk, and I want to hold it, and look at it, and pet it, and it'll be my little pet shiny rock. So, green tier for shiny green rocks. And then, I think B tier for uranium fuel cells. They feel too cheap, I think, which bumps it up in the rankings, but down in the design perspective, because you only need a few shiny green rocks to have enough fuel for what feels like literally forever. And yeah, by the time you get Kovarex going, you have way too many of these, even for the amount of uranium ammo you might want. So, but as far as the fuel cells, I think they're in a pretty good spot. They've got a good amount of power. It feels powerful in a way that's fun, but not so powerful that just a few of them last you the rest of the game or something. And it feels like they're just weak enough that they do push you towards wanting to do the neighbor bonus, right? Of making your nuclear reactors in a square. So, and with the new combinator controls and being able to read the fuel. Oh yeah, these are even higher because you can read how many of them there are. And so now it's way easier to control your nuclear plant so that it only burns fuel when it needs to. And that was doable before, but it was much harder. The spent result. I kind of think this is another one of those things where it's like, what's the point? Because you can easily solve this by just storing all of the. It's more just for the people who think it's cool and want to reprocess them that this exists. Because the actual necessity of them existing from a perspective of, like, saving uranium, it's kind of pointless. as in, you don't need it. You already have so much infinite uranium with this thing. And so, I don't really think this is that important. If you're blowing through a ton of fuel cells, these might start to clog up something, but you can just add storage chests. So they feel kind of pointless. Spent cells get a D. And reprocessing of spent cells gets a D for the same reason. It's useful if you really care about it, but in most of the time, in most of the games, for most of the time, you can just store these and not reprocess them, and you will have zero negative side effects for ignoring the fact that they exist. Now, Covarex. A plus for power level, maybe S. Really strong, gets you infinite shiny bright green rocks, which is important if you want lots of the nuclear fuel or nuclear missiles. Nuclear bombs? Atomic bombs? What are they actually called in this game? One of those three things, I think. Yeah, Vatamouse, that's interesting. Covarex has simplified it to the point where it's too easy and boring. I actually think these two things would be more interesting if Covarex reprocessing didn't exist. So it's kind of like, pick one. You either do this, and that's how nuclear fuel becomes affordable, or you do this, and that makes nuclear fuel more affordable. But let's be honest, you could have neither of these, and uranium processing alone is enough to fuel quite a lot of gigawatts. A really huge base might need a bit more, but like, I think I did the math, and I think on just one patch of uranium, you can usually run like 400 gigawatts to, or not 400 gigawatts, 400 megawatts to like a whole gigawatt of power off of just this recipe with no productivity of any kind. Or something like that. It's pretty crazy. Anyway, these were here. This I'm going to leave a B tier because it's really nice to have infinite green rocks. This is going to be C tier because it's just what you do. Most of your uranium turns into the dull green sad rocks. Let's just appreciate how fun Covarex is as a name for a recipe. It is kind of fun that it's named after a person. All right, and the nuclear fuel, so cool. I love to see trains go fast with nuclear fuel. And now we have legendary nuclear fuel, which is even better. And so now, what is going on here? And so now with legendary nuclear fuel, the trains can go zoom big time. But it's really expensive and it only stacks to one. So A tier. No S tier for you. Oh boy, we're already 30 minutes in. We gotta go faster. Okay. Let's do fish. They spoil now. Fish are so cool. S tier level cool. I don't like that they spoil. That brings them down to C tier for me. Sad. Oh, I forgot about lube. Lube is interesting. I kind of like that it's one of those resources that you want to stockpile. There's not a lot of that going on in Vanilla Factorio. In fact, well, there might be more with Space Age now. But in Vanilla Factorio, before Space Age, this was the only thing you ever needed to stockpile in a sense of like, oh, I don't want to turn all of my heavy oil into petroleum because then I won't have any left to make lube. So you're actually kind of incentivized to like make a stockpile of lube for when you need it for the blue belts or electric engines or whatever else. So I think that's actually pretty cool. I give that a B, mechanics and design wise. Oh, my throat's killing me. This will probably be the last category we do for today. Do we do Gleba next? Do we do one of the other planets? I think I've gotten everything. Other than barrels. I guess rocket parts. How do we feel about rocket parts? I think rocket parts get a solid... They're almost too easy now, but they get a solid B. Rockets are cheap to make. You only need 50 rocket parts to launch a rocket. They only need blue chips. No longer do we need rocket control units. So I think they get a B. Because the new rocket system is pretty fun. It's fun to see a lot of rockets launching. Pretty satisfying. All right, let's start with guess which fluid is which. I have no idea between those three. Which ones? One of them is lube, one of them is cold fluoroketone, and one of them is fluorine, I think. Wait, okay, that's sulfuric acid. And we will do barreling separately, by the way, because this we'll want to measure the merits of barreling each individual fluid. So we will do that, but I'm curious. I don't know which one of these is which. And we'll save that because that's Aquilo stuff. So we'll do that last. But let's, I guess we can talk about barreling now. Barreling water. When do you ever barrel water? Like, who barrels water? F tier. I mean, not true. It's kind of nice. Actually, I totally changed my mind because it's how you get water in small amounts to places that you need it in small amounts with bots. And you don't need to have a pipeline or a belt or a train. So very nice. To be able to barrel water. And particularly in mod packs, though, I know that's not really what we're grading things on, but I feel like barreling water is a lifesaver. Because especially in modded games, there's often some recipes that need just a tiny bit of water. And so you really can supply all that you need with bots. As far as these other things, I never, ever, ever barrel anything other than maybe crude. Like, it's such a rare occurrence. I'm just putting him in F because I never do it. Like, it's nice that I can, I guess, but I'm not going to give it a high grade. It's kind of like, why would you do that? Just make a pipe. Especially with the new pipelines being as strong as they are, they're just, like, amazing, right? Like, you can do whatever you want with the new pipelines. So it feels really, barreling in general feels more unnecessary than it's ever been before. I'm sure there are still some cases where it's fine, but I don't think I barreled. What did I barrel? I barreled something towards the end of the game. Oh, I had to barrel cold fluoroketone to send Synalvis for my fusion reactors. That's literally it. That's all that I, oh yeah. I might have barreled a sulfuric. No, my sulfuric was close to my uranium patch, so I didn't even have to barrel it. But that I do agree that maybe brings that up half a notch for mining purposes. All right. So moving on. Also, it's interesting. You can't barrel all the fluids. I just kind of assumed you could. Didn't even think about it. All right. Let's go Vulcanus. We've already talked about calcite. So let's talk about molten. The molten metals are A tier level. Just insane productivity. Insane ease with which to transport. You know, you can throw them in trains if you want to move molten metals around. That's denser than moving plates around in a wagon. So that's pretty great. A barrel of molten iron. It shows up and it's just a solid cylinder of iron now. Lava. Lava's another one of those interesting, like, it's S tier from a power level perspective, but it's F tier from a design perspective. I find it really, again, I think they probably did it right, Wooba, designing the game, but I don't like it. And it's not because they did anything wrong. It's just because it's so unbelievably basic and easy to turn lava into molten metal. It feels like we needed one more layer of complexity or difficulty in maybe we needed a special pump for the lava, or exactly, Game Biter, maybe we needed special pipes for the lava, or maybe we needed to process the lava one step before turning it into the molten metals. It just felt so easy, like cheat code levels of easy. Like I put a offshore pump just directly in a pool of lava. This thing that doesn't look like it could survive being put in a pool of lava, I will add. And then I just dump that into regular pipes, and then I connect that to a foundry, and I'm done. I add a piece of calcite and now I have infinite everything. I don't know. I didn't love that. It was too easy. I liked Vulcanus overall, but I don't think I really liked the fluid lava. The fluid ingredient of lava I didn't like very much. Visually, the lava pools look really cool, I will say. What else is on Vulcanus? This thing. What is this? This is coal synthesis. That's more of a space platform thing. That's turning carbon into coal, I think. What else was on Vulcanus? I like tungsten carbide and tungsten plates. They just get C. I don't know if we needed two different items. They feel kind of interchangeable. I know one is more expensive than the other, but like we only had one holmium plate. Why did we need two tungsten plates, basically? I don't know. I guess Vulcanus is already too easy, so maybe I shouldn't complain about one thing that made it harder. Holmium gets a C. Holmium ore already took the hit. He died for holmium sins, so holmium plates can have a C because they're fine. Yeah, like what if you needed tungsten to make pipes that could carry lava, and before you have pipes that can carry lava, you can only place foundries right next to a pool of lava because there's maybe some sort of building with a flexible hose that could attach. I know I'm really stretching here in terms of how the game mechanics work, but like the essence of what I'm saying is that what if for a while until you had tungsten pipes, you could only place foundries right next to the lava pools. You know, something like that would have made it feel a bit more balanced. Lava pools just felt so broken as a mechanic of getting metal and copper. Anywho, am I missing anything or did we get all the resources on Vulcanus? I think we did. All right, Fulgora. Holmium solution. Gets a D for our complaints about not being able to easily make quality holmium plates. And is there anything else? Oh, electrolytes. Electrolytes are fine. No complaints about those. Superconductors and supercapacitors. I give supercapacitors a D because it's annoying that you need to offload them to the other planets. Given, I kind of wish everything you needed to make, I don't know. I didn't like supercapacitors, but I don't know why. I think it's because they mostly were only used in equipment. Maybe that's what I'm getting at. Maybe that's what it was. But they probably are fine in C tier. They did what they needed to do. They were mostly unnecessary other than making electromagnetic science and then the equipment. But like, well, I guess what I'm getting at is it's really weird once you shift your frame of reference from, oh, you just need them for your a couple pieces of equipment to like the mech armor, maybe that's what it is, to then the idea of what if you want a legendary mech armor? Well, now you're not talking you just need a few hundred, you're talking you need a few hundred thousand maybe. And that completely changes things where an ingredient that normally would only show up in small amounts once or twice for certain recipes, now you need massive amounts of it if you want those things to be legendary. So, and that's more of an interesting topic around the idea of quality, is like, there are lots of items in the game in Factorio that previously, before quality existed, you would only ever need it in a few hundred at a time. But now, if you're wanting to farm legendary of a certain thing, a thing that normally you would only need a few hundred of once, you now need a few hundred thousand of, which is very different, because that's not something you can just carry in your pocket one time, or send one spaceship full of. So, and again, I'm not saying intrinsically good or bad with that, it just is different with quality. Alright, on to Glaba? Did we get... I'm saving science. Did we get all the... Oh, scrap! Scrap! Scrap is A. I love scrap. I thought scrap was a really cool idea. I thought it was really cool that you only mine one thing. I thought it was really cool how it recycled into a chance-based, you know, output of a bunch of different things. I really liked Fulgora. Needing to recycle everything was cool. I thought holmium output was on the low end to the point where it kind of was slightly annoying. That's why holmium ore is in the F tier. But scrap as a whole, A level. Loved it. Love it. All right. Are we on to Glaba now? Are we on to the Glebes? Oh boy. Now, I know some people would like me to just do this and just keep going, but I'm not going to because that's not actually how I feel. I really liked Glaba. And those of you that didn't get to see my playthrough or haven't watched it or whatever, I really liked Gleba. I didn't understand a lot of the hate for it. There are certainly, it certainly is the hardest planet. So if you dislike it because of its difficulty, that I can see. Disliking it for its mechanics, I struggled more to see because for me, it's like I thought it was the most interesting of all of them. And it was a pain at the beginning when your nutrients that you have are constantly spoiled. Like it's a little bit of a pain to get started. I think one of my top recommendations was just that I think nutrients could have had a longer spoil timer without too much of a negative impact on anything. So like if these could have lasted 10 minutes or something, because getting things started on Gleba was a little frustrating. Like at the first point, you feel really overwhelmed and then you're like, oh, OK, I've got some nutrients in my pocket. So let me plop down this building and try to see if I can run it. But then like 2 minutes later, you're trying to do something again. But now your nutrients have spoiled into spoilage. So then you need to make more nutrients. And it was a bit annoying at first. But the way when you finally started to get things rolling, it felt really cool. The terrain was hard to see stuff visually for sure. I think concrete cleaning the terrain is something that should be in vanilla. And Jordan, also, we talked about this a little bit earlier, but I do think the overgrowth soil, we ranked it low because the overgrowth soil can't be placed anywhere. I think on Gleba, you should be able to place either color of overgrowth soil anywhere. You've worked really hard to get overgrowth soil. You shouldn't still be biome restricted. The problem with biome restricting it is now you're causing players with different map seeds, even in the end game, to not be able to build the same base. And that feels really weird to me. I think once you're in the end game, you shouldn't be still be restricted by the map seed having the green and pink biomes in weird shapes or bad placements or whatever. That doesn't feel like something you should have to deal with in the ultra late game. It's not equivalent to ore patches, Aelor, because ore patches don't spoil. The distance that an ore patch is doesn't really matter. Not to mention, if you actually want to compare it to ore patches, it's very different because big miners mine about 50 billion ore per second and last forever with beacons, whereas agricultural towers, you actually need a large patch to get a lot of stuff. You can't speed it up with beacons. You can't speed it up with modules. So I actually don't think it's equivalent to ore patches at all. When we're talking about the late game, it's actually very different. But yeah, I mean, as for the actual numbers, that's a different conversation. Like, yeah, it does last for an hour, so you can take it pretty far without it being a big deal. But I do think being controlled by the biomes is a weird thing on Gleba. Anyway, that's kind of besides the point here. Jelly Nut, I liked more than Yumako. I think I have no reason. This is a vibe check thing. Jelly Nut gets a B, Yumako gets a C. Yumako's fine. Spoilage shows up everywhere. No complaints. It is what it advertises itself to be. it is spoiled. It is spoiled stuff, and it does what you want. I like the idea of being able to turn some spoilage back into nutrients, so that's fine. I think it all works. And then nutrients, I'm gonna put as D because of what I just said. I think they spoil too fast to the point where it actually gets in the way of just messing around and holding nutrients for a minute, particularly because the spoilage to nutrients recipe, which is the one you start with, starts the nutrients as being half spoiled. Like they literally only last 2.5 minutes. That's 200 seconds. No, 150 seconds. They're gone before you blink. Yeah, so nutrients spoil really fast. I don't mind needing them to run the biochambers though on Gleba. And we already talked about this in the previous episode about biochambers. My hope would be that you need nutrients for biochambers on Gleba, but then somehow you either upgrade them or make a different version of them that can run off of something that doesn't spoil on other planets. But anyway, the ore stuff spoils really freaking fast, but I thought it was cool otherwise, and I liked the loop. They were a little bioflux hungry, They eat a lot of bioflux, but that's also sort of fair because you're producing iron and copper out of them. So, fair enough. Glim, as far as the end game soils, they only let you build in the proper biome. So basically, you have to be in a green biome to put down the green soil, which grows the pink plants. The colors are swapped. I understand it's for visual distinction and contrast. It also, I think, is very confusing to have the pink soil grow the green plants. Or the pink soil grows the pink plant, which makes the green stuff. And then the green soil grows a red plant, which makes the red stuff. That's also confusing. Like, if these are swapped, shouldn't these be swapped too? Shouldn't that be a more greenish plant to follow the same pattern? Whatever it is, I think it was somewhat confusing to me. Anyway, Yamako was a C. That's fine. And Yamako Mash is a C. I like the jelly a lot. I love the look of it. It looks tasty. I want to eat it. I want to eat a bite of it. I want that jelly. And it makes lots of power for your base when you throw it in heating towers. I'm going to give it an A. That jelly, the gelatinous cube, I think was my favorite thing on Gleba. Seeing big belts of the jelly just go around your base, I just visually looks really cool. I like the jelly. I'm not going to put it at S. That would be ridiculous. But I like the jelly. Oh, yes. Yes. S tier for the eggs. No, not S tier. But it was really fun to have a pile of them spoil in my inventory, because that creates a moment that is unlike any other in Factorio. And it's also really fun that you can produce enemies on demand. So I'll give them an A level. A level. What else we got here? Carbon? Carbon's on asteroids before, or on space platform before it's on Gleba. Ooh, the seeds. The seeds I give a C. C for seed. Nothing too crazy going on there. They did what they needed to do. Once you have the biochambers, you start farming extra seeds. Before that, you just are maintaining, so that's all fine. I don't know how to rank this one because I didn't touch them. But given I ranked wood as F, I'll rank this as D because I realize there's quite a lot of utility in planting your own forests so that pollution doesn't spread. So I'll give that slightly higher. Ooh, carbon fiber. Yeah. Carbon fiber. It's fine. It does what it needs to do. It's like tungsten, you know, and holmium. I didn't find it particularly interesting for any reason, but it's fine. Bioflux was cool. I liked the idea of needing both fruits, and you process both fruits into something that spoils quickly, but then you process that back into something that doesn't spoil quickly. I thought was cool for Bioflux. Someone was mentioning this about the agricultural science, which this is probably more a point that we need to make for the agricultural science, but the recipe is too easy because it doesn't require something that spoils quickly. I think the agricultural science should reflect more on your overall production line, but because Bioflux spoils in 2 hours, it's not a fast enough spoilage time where you actually feel pressured to make your whole thing efficient to get relatively unspoiled agricultural science. Because the eggs also have like a 15 minute timer, and they get produced with the max timer. So it's really easy to make agricultural science that's kind of unspoiled. Tree seeds are kind of a decoration. Yeah, it is cool that you can plant trees. I do think, though, one issue is that you can't plant trees in the desert, which, again, I know lore-wise is how actual trees work in real life. But I think one of the things you want as the Factorio engineer is to have control over the environment. And feeling like, oh, well, I started in a desert biome and I have literally no way to even plant trees now. Whereas if it just makes it feel even more up to random chance rather than your progress through the game. So I think if you could plant seeds in the desert, that would be nice, but they made it so that's not possible. You know, just make it so that you have to feed your agricultural tower with water, and then you can plant them anywhere. I think most players would prefer that over not being able to plant them in the desert. I feel like I'm missing something for Gleba, but I don't see anything. All right, well, I guess we'll move to Aquilo then. And then I guess space. I mean, carbon is probably gonna get a C no matter what. It's fine. It shows up in space and on Gleba, so. I do like that you can turn spoilage into carbon. That was fun. All right, on to Aquilo. Let's see. Ammonia ocean, cool mechanic. I give it a B. Not having water. But that's this stuff. That's the ammonia. Lithium. Okay, so quick thought. I'm trying to think of just which items it applies to. I felt that Aquilo was way too fast. It just felt really easy to get lithium. Like, okay, you mine the brine, you do the thing, you combine it with holmium, boom, lithium plates. It just, I don't know, it was kind of a bing, bang, boom, done situation. But I don't think that's a knock on any of these in particular. I think maybe... I liked collecting it as a fluid. Maybe this step felt too easy. I'm gonna knock that down a peg. And then fluorine. I don't know. It felt easy too. It's like, okay, well, you get the fluorine and then you just mix it with two things that you already have to make the other stuff, and now you have the fluoroketones. But the fluoroketone is a cool, I like the hot cold loops. I've always liked those in mod packs, and I'm really happy that we finally have that in a base level Factorio, so I think that's really cool. So I'll give those a B. And then the quantum processors are cool. I'll give those a B just because they're neat and expensive and they require something from every planet, which is neat to have that thing that requires all the things. I do think it was weird that we needed more holmium than anything else on Aquilo. Like, that felt like an interesting decision because, like, you need all three things for this guy, but for the lithium, you only needed holmium. Which probably has its root in how real life works. I don't know. But anyway, plasma, S tier. So cool. I love plasma. Who doesn't? I wish we could weaponize it. You know, point a fusion generator at an enemy and open the hatch and see what happens. But apart from that, fusion reactors are really cool, so the plasma gets an S. Shubidoo, yes, it is all of the above. You can see our grading criteria here at the bottom. It's kind of, especially with the intermediates, a lot of it is just vibe check because these are kind of all necessary. So a lot of the grade for these is based on either what they make or how much we like them. GameBiter, I loved Aquilo. I felt like it was too short, was kind of my sadness about Aquilo. Okay, so now let's talk about biter eggs. Biter eggs, we kind of touched on this with the captive biter spawner ranking. A really cool mechanic. Weird that they look like pine cones. And a little bit weird that you have to transport them back to Gleba. Kind of a cool, like, bounce back and forth to get the overgrowth soil. But that's fine. What's this? Coal synthesis? That's a C. It's something you needed. It's a fine recipe. It lets you make coal out of carbon. Thruster fuel. Totally fine. I liked it. I mean, it's very easy and simplistic. You know, I think they did a good job with that. I like that they gave you a second recipe for it when you got more advanced, so you could use the calcite to make it a little cheaper. But it didn't really feel like it was that expensive in the first place. Cole synthesis felt more like a D because it, yeah, I guess it's hard because you do need it on a space station, so it's not a very powerful recipe. So it is a D in that sense. But it also is like, I think it's supposed to be expensive to make coal in space. So in that sense, it's doing what it's supposed to. How do I feel about the recipe? That's really how we need to grade this. How do I feel about coal synthesis? I think it's a C. all right, so we're getting down to the brass tacks here. Fusion. Now, I gave fusion itself an A tier. Can I give the fuel cells a higher tier than the actual thing? I don't think so. I think fusion should be an A. And then these things are just barreling ketones. I think this is barreling cold fluoroketones. I get a B because it's fine. And it's what you need to do for fusion stuff. Barreling fluorine and the other hot ketones, you'd never do. Whatever. Those are Fs. I think that's what those are. All right, now on to the science packs. All right, so let's arrange them in gameplay order. Military goes there. Yes, okay. So, red science. Red science is the one science that I think every player who's ever played Factorio actually has completed. If you haven't done red science yet, you haven't even really played the game. Like, I don't... This is almost like if you've done it, you've played the game. If you haven't done it, you haven't really played Factorio yet. You've made two pieces of iron. So, I don't know if it gets S for that, though. Red packs go in everything. They're iconic. They are the science. But I'll give them A. Green science, I always felt like... is this really interesting bump up, because it's like it's more expensive and it's more complex, but it's still really easy. Like red and green feel very close together, whereas green and blue feel way further apart than that. So I'll keep green at C. I'll put military science. I don't like military science. I don't like making it. I often don't like doing the researches that need it because I don't do the military that much. I'm putting it at D. I don't like having to make grenades and walls for a science pack. I actually dislike this one for the same reasons. I don't like having to make electric furnaces and rails. It's very interesting because from a game design perspective, I mean, they literally talked about this when they changed it. They do that so that the player doesn't have as much friction in their playthrough, because they were going to make electric furnaces anyway, right? And then they also want purple science. And so you end up doing both at the same time. You only need to make electric furnaces once, and now you have electric furnaces and you don't need it separately, right? And so that's nice. But at the same time, and I mean, green science is the same thing, but they're such cheap buildings that that doesn't feel like it's quite the same. It's nice, but personally, I don't think I don't need that kind of handholding where like you pigeonhole me into making the building I need to make by telling me I need to make that building for a science. And so I think I prefer the ones that use intermediates as ingredients rather than buildings. Nullius, first, like I really liked Nullius. It's actually one of my favorite overhaul mods of all time. So I'll just start by saying that. It is one of my favorite overhaul mods of all time. I did find the, like, to make a building, you need these buildings, and to make this building, you need these buildings, and it's just like this crazy chain of buildings being ingredients in other buildings, and it's like, wait a second, like, are there any intermediates in this whole thing? So, anywho. Blue science. I feel like blue science gets a B for being blue, and it also gets a B for being, it's the gateway to the game. It feels like once you've gotten chem science, you really start to get to play the game. Like you get to start to unlock all sorts of cool things. A lot of the fun techs are locked behind blue science. Feels like things are really getting going there. Space is interesting. Space, I think, gets a D. It's so cheap. I like it. So, I mean, maybe that makes it a B because it's so easy. It's just really easy. I liked making my first space platform. It was really fun. It's either a B or D. I don't feel neutral on it. Whatever it is, it's not C. But it feels like it's really, it was really easy to make enough for the entire game. I guess I wish I needed to make more, which means I liked it, which means maybe it should be B tier. Because I kind of wish the game had given me a reason to amp up my space science production, and it never did. But that's just true of all the packs to some level, just because the SPM that you need is going up, but they also give you biter labs and productivity modules, and so, and you take longer to do things as you're playing later and later in the game. So you're the needed SPM, even though the needed science for each research is going up, I feel like your needed SPM as a player is not really going up that much as you go throughout the game. And on top of that, you're getting more productivity. So I really never felt like I needed to ramp up science production, like at all, which I think is fine gameplay wise. I think a mod pack can fix that for players that want it different. Space has zero ongoing cost. Yeah, that's kind of what, one of the things I was thinking about too, is once you set it up, you never need to touch it again. But that's true of other science packs, assuming you have your iron and copper patches are, you know, still going. So it feels different, but it's also not. I think it's just mainly different because it's in space and it's not touching your other infrastructure. All right, yellow is the one that gets you logistic science, so that's an A. And by that I mean the one that gives you requester chests and logistics bots doing the thing you want them to do. All right, now we get to these packs. I thought these packs were all actually pretty fine. I don't have too many. The only thing is the agricultural pack might be a little easy to create in a very unspoiled nature, but at the same time, I don't think Gleba should have been harder. Requester chests are space, not yellow. Is that true? Really? I thought something was still behind yellow. Oh, wow. Well, in that case, we're switching those. I had that backwards in my mind. I thought we still needed this to get requester chests. But yeah, the logistics system, I'm looking it up. It's in the Space Age mod. Yeah, behind Space Science. Okay, cool. All right, this guy, cryogenic packs. They look the coolest. I mean, they gotta be at least B tier on that alone. And I don't think I can take them higher than that though. They're fine. You know, you gotta bring all the various things to Aquilo to make these and then you send them back. I think I maybe was hoping it felt a bit more epic once I made this. It kind of was like, well, it's just like the other three. I think I wanted this one to feel a bit more unique compared to the other three. It kind of felt like the same thing over again. And then there's this guy, which I didn't actually make in my playthrough. I got close. I got to the point where I had Promethium chunks on the ship. I just didn't fly it back over Navis and collect biter eggs because something, what was the reasoning? Something, I don't remember why I didn't want to do it. Maybe it was just too much of a pain in the butt, but it's only used in one place. So that knocks it down a grade because it's kind of a boring research. But like, it's not even an exciting one. It's an exciting boost to get more free research, but actually, no, I digress. It's not an exciting boost to get free research. It's nice as a player when numbers go up, yes. But again, it's back to that idea of, is it really that interesting to look at your tech tree and see the research that used to cost $2,000 has a slash through it, and now it says $19.50. You know, it's like, oh, a discount. Like, that's all it is, and that's the only thing it does. So it's a pretty boring usage. I do wish there was something that I was out of quantum processors. That's what it was. Thank you. I was completely out of quantum processors, and we were needing to wait for like the carbon fiber to work its way through the whole system to give me more. And yeah, that's what it was. Yeah, I was definitely too lazy to do something. I remembered that much. Anyway, all that to say, I don't think this science is that interesting. I think on the one hand, it's good to have some endgame stuff that doesn't have too much important behind it. Otherwise, then it feels like it's not really an endgame thing. It's a thing you need to do to beat the game. It also felt like it could have been slightly more than just one of the most boring numbers in the game, which is research costs go down, because that's all it does. Which is a similar complaint that I ended up figuring out. This was after the video. My complaint about the Biter Labs, or are they called Bio Labs officially? I don't remember. But the Biter Labs, I think, were boring to me, and I gave them a lower grade. At the end of the day, I think it's because what they actually do is just give you that discount. They cross out the previous price of your entire tech tree. Everything that said 2,000, cross it out. Now it's got a 1,000 written next to it. And that's all it does. Whereas productivity researches are at least slightly more interesting, because more items end up on belts, and that means you need to deal with more transportation of them, and you might use them faster. Like, but reducing the cost of the researches doesn't change a single shred of what's going on in your base. It just means that when you're actually consuming the packs, they get consumed slightly slower. And like, it is a strong bonus, don't get me wrong, it's just not an interesting bonus. Like, if you're mega basing and going late, surely you will do it. It's just not that interesting, that's all. But not everything needs to be interesting. I also want to point out, like, engines are important. I might put them in the D tier, but that doesn't mean that they're bad, right? Not everything needs to be interesting in your game. Sometimes you can just have a boring bonus here or there. That's fine. All right, we did it. Tier maker, we have done the intermediates tab. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. It's been a lot of fun doing this. I'm excited to do the rest. We still have the space tab and the ordering of planets to talk about. So that'll be the next video. And then the final one will be the military. And then we will have done all the stuff in the game. And I could even do one for enemies, but that feels a little boring because it would just be talking about biters, asteroids, and pentapods, and demolishers. I guess there's four categories of enemy. Maybe we could do an enemies one. It's hard though, because I feel like we'll probably just talk about the enemies in the military thing. I don't think we're going to tier list every single enemy, because they're kind of all the same, just at different difficulty levels. So that's probably not worth its own video. We'll just talk about the enemies in the military one. Anyway, as always, thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you think down in the comments. If you're here live, stick around, we'll chat for a few more minutes. But from those of you in the future from YouTube, thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.